from the Born-Landry equation or Born-Haber cycle. Okay, and for Born-Landry equation, Avogadro number may not be given, pi may not be given, c may not be given, E0 may not be given, because those are well known and you have to remember those. And z plus z minus you can find from the molecule as well. Okay, for NaCl it is 1, 1. Okay, others should be given, like N must be given, R0 must be given, and the Madelung constant must be given. Okay, other you have to remember, those are the well known formula, may be given, may not be given, but you have to remember. Now the question may arise in your mind that why we have used an extra term, Madelung constant, and what is the significance of this term? Okay, actually, if we consider that, I have probably little explained you, say this is a unit cell. Okay, when we are considering a unit cell, it is having, unit cell means one, say, face center cube. Near to this face center cube, here other face center cube are also present, and the we are considering this, say, Cl minus. This Cl minus is interacting with this one, or this one, or the chloride or sodium present in the next layer, next cubic cube, which is near to this. So like this way, nearby cube, the chloride and sodium Cl minus Na plus present in nearby cube, also interacting with a particular chlorine. And Cl minus is having repulsion with the other Cl, nearby Cl minus, and Cl minus having attraction with other Na plus. Similarly, you can consider with respect to Na plus. And this is the basis of the Madelung constant, that not up to the infinity level, up to certain level, here is the attraction and repulsion forces present. And that is why we must have to add some correction term in the energy. Okay, so that correction to calculate that correction term, if we consider a one cube, face centered cube, say, so six nearby chlorine is present around a sodium. If we are considering only one sodium, then as sodium coordination number is 6, so nearby chlorine is present 6, having the highest attraction. Now on the next cube, surrounded cube, not that only one cube we are considering, surrounded cube, here we have only given the one cube, but here also another cube may be present, here another cube may be present, so it is a giant. And around the cube total, if you draw it, you will see that 12 next Na plus is having at the distance root 2r. Okay, root 2r means
phase diagram.
Opposite to the phase phase diagonal.
Sir, if you are saying anything, perhaps you are mute. At least your voice isn't reaching.
Network issue over.
Now it is visible. And you can see that when we are considering one Na plus ion, if it is a face-centered cube, so the nearest Cl minus is present over here. So it is at distance r. Okay. If we consider that the other Na plus is present, like in the corner, another Na plus is present. So the distance is root 2 r. 12 next Na plus present, 6 nearest, as the coordination number of Na plus is 6. So 6 nearest Cl minus present at r minus r distance. 12 nearest, if you count those Na plus at root 2 r distance, you will find that 12 nearest Na plus ion is present. And those are having the repulsion with the Na plus we have selected. Next level, at root 3 r distance, root 3 r means it is present in the next cube, in the same cube, but at the corner of the cube, not corner of the face, rather corner of the cube. At that position, the 8 next Cl minus ion is present. And corner of this cube, 2 cube when we are considering, it is having 6 nearest Na plus and next 24 nearest Cl minus at root 5 r distance. So it is very difficult to consider. You have to think the total figure, and around that you have to count. Okay. So from here, if we calculate the energy is minus 6. 6 is for number present. 6, Z minus 1, Z2 means the charge on anion and cation E square by R. And minus sign means it is attractive force. Attraction, that is why minus, because stabilize, and the repulsion with positive sign. 12 chlorine, 12 sodium having the repulsion with the sodium we have considered. That is why plus 12 Z1 Z2 is square. And here Z1 Z2 is same because both the sodium. Okay. In case of here also Z1 Z2 is 1 1. Okay, so we are considering this, and from here we are considering this equation, and we have, it is possible to calculate the value of A is 1.7476. However, you may consider it up to the infinite level, but Meidulam constant is calculated only considering this, because of, in most of the cases, the geometry up to 6th level, here is the attraction or repulsion is important. So we are considering average this value, and when we are considering the other layer, it is having very little influence on the Meidulam value. Okay, so up to 4 digit you may consider it as this value. And for a particular crystal lattice like sodium chloride, here this is the value. For cesium chloride, this is the value. For zinc blend, this is the value. For wurtzite and for fluorite, this is the value.
Do we have to remember all of these values?
No. If in your exam, if it is given to calculate the lattice energy using Bond-Lande equation, then we will supply the Meidulam constant. No need to remember it. The question may come, what is the significance of Meidulam constant? Then you have to give this considering the example of NaCl. Okay?
Yes.
So, medulla constant for sodium chloride is this, and since the value is constant depend only the geometry of the crystal. Geometry of the crystal, and the value will be same for all other solid which exhibit the NaCl structure. So means having NaCl structure and having same structure and the charge on the anion cation if same, so medulla value of medullum constant is also same. Okay, and this is due to the considering the attraction and repulsion by the nearby anion and cation present in the lattice up to the distance where if repulsion or attraction is present. Okay, you may also consider up to the infinity distance, but it will little influence on the value. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so this is about the ionic bond. So it is a, in ionic bond we have discussed that it is having the electrostatic attraction and that is stabilized in the crystal lattice using Born-Arba cycle. It is possible to calculate, but it is not exactly matching with the value. For exact calculation or for more closer calculation, we can choose the Born-Lander equation. And also it is possible to calculate the radius ratios to know what should be the structure for a particular anion and cation. So now we are moving to the next topic, that is the metallic bond. Okay, in case of iron metal, in a iron rod, if it is pure iron, do not consider the steel. Steel is not the pure iron, but it is a alloy. So in case of pure iron, it is also only the iron atom is present. And here the iron atom is tightly held together to give the iron rod. And that is the force present between them is known as metallic bond. Okay, so it is very different than the bond we have considered in case of ionic bond. This is because the metal is electropositive and both the electronegativity difference of both the Fe atom is same. So to explain the type of attraction present or type of force present, or to explain the metallic bond, we are considering the different model. First is valence bond model, electron C model, and band theory model. These three we will consider. First one is valence bond model. Okay. In case of, here we have considered the lithium metal. Probably if it is possible to perform the laboratory, then you can see the sodium metal. Okay, sodium metal is very soft and you can cut it using the knife. But problem is it is highly reactive in air. So you have to keep it within the some liquid, petroleum or kerosene. Okay, so like lithium also very much reactive. And here when we are considering the lithium metal, the bond present between two lithium atoms, then we have to consider that in lithium, the valence electron, one electron is present in valence shell. Okay, so this one electron, it may share with other lithium to give this type of bond. Okay, and like the resonance, here this lithium may share its electron to any of the lithium, nearby lithium. The nearby lithium is closely packed, so it may share the electron with any of the lithium, like the resonance structure. So in fact, we can consider this type of different structure, like the resonance in benzene, which we'll discuss later. Resonance means this lithium may share its electron to any of the nearby lithium. So when it is sharing with this, it is forming bond here. When it is sharing with this, both the but, this electron must be available, it is taking from here, so it is negative charge. Or it is not sharing, so it is positive charge, electron had given to the other lithium. So this type of bond may be present. Or you may think in this way, lithium-lithium is sharing, here lithium-lithium is sharing like this. So sharing is possible any of the lithium. And also it is possible that lithium can form lithium plus and other lithium may form lithium minus when one s2 electron is donated to the other lithium to 2s2. Okay, so lithium is having 1s2 hydrogen, then lithium. Hydrogen, then lithium. So lithium is having 1s2, 2s1. So if it gives 2s1 to the other lithium, so this will lithium minus and this will lithium plus. Like this way, it may have electrostatic attraction as well. So either covalent attraction or electrostatic attraction, due to resonance, it may interact with the nearby all the lithium present in the metal. And that is why here is a sharing of electron and it forms a strong association of lithium metal, which is known as the metallic bond as per the valence bond theory. Valence bond model means valence electron is sharing or donating to the nearby lithium to form the bond, metallic bond. Is it clear? Here, if we consider this model, it is very difficult to explain the some metallic properties. As you are aware that the metals are good conductor of heat and electricity. I think my voice is clear.
Yes, sir. Okay.
Yes, sir.
So this is not possible to explain how it is good conductor of electricity and heat. That we can explain using the electron C model. In case of electron C model, here we are considering that the lithium ions are actually inserted in a sea of the electrons or immersed in a sea of the electrons. From where the electron C comes? Electron C comes, see, the electron configuration of lithium is 1s2, 2s1. So all the lithium is donating the 2s1 electron. And it is coming L plus plus E. And this electron coming from all the lithium ion, lithium atom is forming a electron C. and any of the electron may share by any of the plus ion to form a electron C, and the lithium plus is immersed within this C. Actually, neither of the electron is sharing particularly by one of the ions. All those electrons moving freely within a particular zone. So that is why it is reflecting the light, means shiny appearance of the metal, because the light is reflecting from the electron C. Because light is also a wave and electron is also a wave. So it is reflecting from the C, electron C. And it is also possible to conduct the heat, as heat is conducted by the, especially electricity is conducted by the electrons, and heat is also conducted by the electrons, or the charge is conducting the heat. Okay. And here it is possible to also give the shape. Means foil is possible, as if we may apply the force, one layer may detach and it form a, this type of shape forming is possible. Okay, so electron C model, it is, here is the metallic property, last chart, density, melting point and hardness, malleability, ductility, and conduction of heat, conduction of electricity. All those properties of metals, you may read that one, or you may already aware about that, is explained from the electron C model by considering this electron C model. However, here a useful qualitative model of metallic bond we must have to consider as band theory model. Although it is explaining all the facts, but we must have to consider a qualitative model. Okay, for that we are considering the band theory model, which is almost similar with the molecular orbital theory, which is explained in the covalent bonding. Okay, it is molecular orbital theory for metallic bond or band theory model. In case of band theory model, here we are considering the formation of lithium-lithium bond, and when the valence shell is interacting, say 2s is the valence shell of the one lithium, so when 2s is interacting other 2s, it is two atomic orbital is interacting, giving the same number of orbital. One is low energy orbital and other is high energy orbital. If you consider this is the 2s of one lithium, this is the 2s of other lithium, so when they are interacting, they are giving same number of molecular, same number of orbital. Okay, one is lower energy, this is bonding, and one is higher energy. And as it is having single electron, so both the electron present is lower energy, which is known as bonding, and other is antibonding. And both the electron present is bonding, and that is why the energy is decreased, it becomes stabilized. Is it clear? But not that one lithium is interacting with other lithium. It may interact with the nearby lithiums. So when it is interacting with two other lithium, in that case, here it is interacting with one lithium to give bonding and antibonding, when it is interacting other lithium, one orbital is non-bonding, means it is not having, it is having almost same energy with the atomic orbital. It is neither lower energy nor the higher energy, means almost it is do not having interaction, just it is present. Okay, similarly, not three, it is having four. If we consider four, then here is other bonding antibonding. If we consider six, bonding antibonding like this, this type of bonding orbital, closely spaced bonding orbital and closely spaced antibonding orbital is present in a metal having higher number of ions, higher number of metal atoms. So for 10, 5 bonding and 5 antibonding orbital is present, which is very closely spaced. And actually those bonding orbitals are overlapping each other to create the band. And as in a metal set, here is number of atoms present. It is maybe 100,000, or it is difficult to Avogadro number in one mole. Means you can consider that how much greater is the number. And actually this is overlapping with the antibonding because of the very closely spaced orbitals, very closely spaced higher number of bonding orbitals and higher number of antibonding orbitals. And this bonding orbitals is known as, actually, say for 2s, it is having one bonding, one antibonding. For 4 lithium, it is having two bonding, two antibonding, and bonding having the electrons. For n number of lithiums, here is closely spaced bonding orbitals, n number of bonding or n by 2 number of bonding orbitals, and closely spaced n by 2 number of antibonding orbitals. And actually this is overlapping. From the figure you can understand, this is 2, this is 3, this is 4, this is 7. For the odd number, one non-bonding orbital must be present. If it is even number, then there is no non-bonding. So actually it is forming a band. One is valence band and one is conduction band, or vacant non-bonding orbitals coming from vacant non-bonding orbitals, and those are overlapping. To explain the conduction of electricity and heat, you can consider that as it is overlapped with the conduction band, this is antibonding vacant orbital is known as conduction band. So as the valence band is overlapping with the conduction band, so electron can easily move from the valence band to conduction band to conduct the electricity and heat. Okay, so here is the conductor for the, that is why those are the good conductor here. Valence band and conduction band is overlapping each other. In case of semiconductor, the energy gap is little smaller. There is little energy gap which we can overcome by supplying some energy like doping or supplying voltage, so electron can jump in a special condition. But in case of insulator like wood, rubber, those are insulator, because of very large band gap, it is not possible to send a electron from the valence band to the conduction band. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So from here, it is possible to explain the good conduction of metal, and it is also possible to quantitative explanation of the classification of conductor, semiconductor, insulator. Okay, that is why, and it is also very much close to the molecular orbital theory. That is why better to explain the, consider the band theory to explain the metallic bonds. Okay. So now in case of metal, here also the lattice structure may be present in metal, like in the previous. But here the lattice structure is not exactly having the negative positive ion. Here all the positive ions or all the metal ion is present. So here lattice may be also similar to FCC, means face centered cube, body centered cube, hexagonal cross packing, but here all ion is metals having the same size. So you can see the crystal. This is the, this is the close packing, hexagonal close packing. This is most common, hexagonal close packing, or here face center tube or body center tube is present. Like in aluminium, it is face center tube. In case of cadmium, it is body center tube. And here is the grain boundary, means different structure is present, then it is separated with the other structure. Those are known as grain boundary, and it forms a particle. Those are the small crystal structure which is separated from the other crystal structure, and it forms a particle. This is separated by a grain boundary. Okay. Chromium having the body centered cube, cobalt having the HPC, means hexagonal close, HCP, hexagonal close packing, copper, FCC. So you may remember it, but you must have the knowledge, you should have the knowledge that it is forming particular lattice structure. Okay, and those lattice structure is separated with a grain boundary, and different grains are present in a particular particle or particular structure. Now, here one thing we must have to consider, that the crystal lattice is not perfect in its structure, especially when we are considering in case of the compounds, oxides or chlorides, that is ionic compounds. Those are also forming this type of lattice, crystal lattice structure, but those crystal lattice is not perfect, means here must be some sort of defect presence, irregularities present. Irregularity means here may be one anion or cation is displaced or misplaced. Displaced means it is not present in the crystal structure, place is vacant, or misplaced means it may be present except the position, it may be present any of the position in between the structure. Okay, so those are irregularities, and irregularities is very much important in terms of the properties of the ionic compounds. And as the time is not permitting, we will discuss in details about the defects in crystal structure in the next class.
Thank you, sir.
So if you have query, you may ask. Otherwise, we can leave. Please wait. Yes, please.
Sir, can you please upload this document, Word document